Hey guys, Riley Chase here with Hostify, and today I'm going to be talking about this error message when you're trying to connect a VPN user to a USG L2TP IPsec VPN connection, but you're getting this error message that the network connection between you and your computer or your computer or the VPN server could not be established because the remote server is not responding. Now, if you've already connected before, you know that the VPN's working. And you know there's not a connection issue between the, you know, with the internet's up on the other side and there's nothing in the way that could be blocking it, then what's probably happening is that the user's already connected and you can't connect a second time when the same user's already connected. So what I'm going to show you today is how to fix this problem. If you go to devices, what you're going to need to do is get SSH'd into the USG. Now, because I'm remote and remotely located and I don't have a VPN connection, I can't open up PuTTY and connect to it. So one trick that I have to still be able to connect to the USG is if you first go to settings here actually, and you enable advanced features right here, check this box and click apply. That's gonna allow you to get terminal access to your UniFi devices from within UniFi, like that's pop-up that I was just showing. Now, one problem with this is that the terminal access, for some reason, it works on all the devices, but it doesn't work on the USG. So I'm going to open up a connection to this access point and then SSH into the USG from the access point. So I'm going to type in SSH, the IP address of the USG, which is 192.168.1.1. Hit enter, and it's going to ask for a password. Password can be found under settings and then device authentication. So I'm going to copy and paste that password in there. And so now I'm logged into the USG. And the command that I'm going to run is show VPN IPsec SA. And this is going to show that there's already a connection that's established. And this is the problem, is there's already another PC. I've actually got it pulled up here in a virtual machine. And this computer has already connected to the VPN, so now my computer can't connect to the same connection. And this also might happen if you turn off your computer without hitting the disconnect button. There's different ways that you can get stuck like this where the connection's still open even though you're trying to log in again. So we can see that's connected. The next thing we're going to do is restart the VPN service. And there's just two commands to do this. Sudo VPN, oh no, sorry, sudo service xl2tpd restart. That's going to restart the L2TP server. And then the other command is sudo IPsec restart. And this is going to restart the IPsec service. And once this is done, we can do show VPN IPsec SA, and that's going to show now there's no return from that. There's no input output from that. So there's no longer, this user's no longer connected. And if I go back here, I can see that they've been kicked off the VPN. So now I can reconnect here and it will work. And so I'm not going to do it in the video here because it'll disconnect my Loom video session, but now, so anytime that this issue comes up, you know, make sure that, you know, you can go through these steps to remove any users that are already connected. Now this command, these commands will kick off all the users. And so it's not a perfect solution. And, the other way to do it is to reboot the USG, but that's worse because it kicks everyone off the network entirely. So, this is an issue that's not going to go away soon from what I've read. It's an issue with the L2TP protocol, so there's not going to be like a firmware fix for this coming out anytime soon for the USG. And if you run into this issue a lot, you know, try to remind users to properly disconnect before they turn off their computer is one way to, you know, help. But you know, another way, you could run a script that automatically clears VPN sessions or something, but that would kick everyone off the network, so that's not really a solution either. So if this is really an issue for you, you'll probably need to get a different router that supports something like OpenVPN or like different types of VPNs that won't have this problem because they monitor and disconnect dead connections and or something like that, where they'll have you know, they won't have this issue. So hopefully this video was helpful for you. If it was, please give us a thumbs up on YouTube and subscribe to our channel for more videos. And if you need any help troubleshooting this issue, you can also reach out to us on live chat at hostify.net. Thanks.